Welcome back to the second hour. We are discussing about moment distribution method. Some introduction. Now coming to the procedure, we have some four major steps. Coming to the first step, whether it may be continuous beam or it may be a rigid frame, it is assumed to be fixed end moments due to end to be fixed end moments due to external loads are obtained. Even though it is continuous beam or rigid frame, all the individual members are assumed to be fixed, and fixed end moments due to external loads are obtained. For example, if a particular member in a continuous beam or rigid frame is assumed to be fixed, both the ends, subjected to an eccentric point load, distance A and B, it is unsymmetrically loaded in a span of L, then for this fixed end moment, that is MFAB, is given by this formula PAB squared by L squared. The same thing are exercised in slope deflection method also. And if you want fixed end moments at this end, it is PA squared, far away distance is to the square, B by L squared. That is fixed end moment for an eccentric point load. If a beam is subjected to UDL throughout of intensity W kilonewton per meter, then fixed end moment at this point is given by WL squared by 12. And because of symmetrical loading, this moment also WL squared by 12. Now, if we have point load at mid-span, then fixed end moment MFAB, this one, is given by WL by H. And because of symmetrical loading, mid-span loading, fixed end moment at this end also WL by H. This formula we have to remember. Suppose if a beam or member is subjected to uniformly varying load and maximum at the center like this of intensity W kilonewton per meter, then fixed end moment MFAB is phi WL squared by 96. Because of symmetrical loading, MFBA is also phi WL squared by 96. Now, if UVL Or it is in the shape of a triangular load like this, maximum at the left end. Then left end fixed end moment is WL squared by 20, and right end fixed end moment is WL squared by 30. If the maximum intensity is at the right support, then these two will interchange. Now then, there will be fixed end moment because of the sinking of the support. If both ends are fixed, then it is 6EI delta by L square and 6EI delta by L square. The same convention of the things we will see when we deal numerical problem. That is the first step, calculation of fixed end moments. Eccentric loading, PAB squared by L square and PA squared B by L square as shown in the figure. For UDL, it is WL squared by 12 at both the ends. If UDL is for some portion of the beam, not for the full length of the beam, then it should be calculated making use of a small integration that we will see in the numerical problem. If there is a point load at the mid span, then WL by 8 will be the fixed end moment at both the ends, and for triangular load, these are the formulae. And if there is a moment, then fixed end moment will be given by this formula. We have to remember, and we have used in slope deflection method also, and this will be the fixed end moment due to sinking. That is calculating the fixed end moments of all the members by assuming all the members are fixed. It will be the first step. The second step is calculation of stiffness factor. Now, this stiffness factor depends upon the end condition of the beam. If the beam is hinged or simply supported at both the ends, it is for individual beams, not the continuous beam, then K, stiffness or stiffness factor, will be 3EI by L. E is Young's modulus, I is moment of inertia, L is the length of the beam. If the beam is hinged or simply supported at one end and fixed at other end, then stiffness factor will be 4EI by L. Now, most importantly, this, because we solve mainly continuous beam and rigid frames wherein there will be number of members, and stiffness of members in continuous beams and rigid frames. Stiffness of all intermediate members, K, will be 4EI by L. In a continuous beam, if you have intermediate joints like this, or in a frame these joints, they are all intermediate joint. For all these type of intermediate joints, stiffness will be 4 EI divided by L as usual. E is Young's modulus, I is moment of inertia, and L is the length of the beams, length of the B portions, L. Okay, 4 EI by L for all intermediate members. Stiffness of edge members now that depends upon edge support. For the edge members, if edge support is fixed, then K will be 4 EI by L, that is EO. If the this is fixed, for this member it is 4 EI by L. If the edge support is hinged or roller, if this is hinged or roller, then for this member it is 3 EI by L. For all this intermediate member, this EI intermediate member, the stiffness factor is 4 EI by L, whereas for this it will become 3 EI by L, because it is the end member and the far end or edge support is hinged. Now for this also it is same, 4 EI by L, because the edge support is fixed. That is the stiffness factor of the beams. Now for example, here you see, in a continuous beam A, B, C, D, A is fixed, C, it is roller support. KBA, stiffness of this portion, KBA, it is 4 EI by L. If moment of inertia is 2I, then 4E into 2I by H is the stiffness of KBA. Coming to KBC, this is the end support and it is roller. If the end support is other than fixed support, then it is 3 EI by L. That is moment of inertia of this member CB or BC is I only, therefore it is 3 EI by 4. Then coming to KCB, now this will become an intermediate joint, intermediate member, because it is going to an intermediate support. It will be 4 EI by L, that is 4 EI into by 4. It will be EI only, whatever it is. Then coming to KCD, for overhanging portion, stiffness factor will be 0. That is an example for the calculation of stiffness factor. Now, when several members meet at a joint and a moment is applied at the joint to produce the rotation without translation of the member, then the moment distributed among all the members meeting at that joint is proportional to their stiffness. For example, here if we are distributing the moment at this joint, it will be proportional to this 4EI by L, and this it is proportional to this 4EI by L. Now the next step is distribution factor. Distribution factor for the members meeting at a point at the intermediate joint is based on the stiffness coefficient or stiffness of the members. The distribution factor will be the stiffness of that member divided by sum of the relative stiffness at that joint. Now, for example, if there are three members, then distribution factor will be k1 by k1 plus k2 plus k3, and for the second member it will be k2 by the sum of the stiffness factors at the joint. And if distribution factor for the third member will be stiffness factor of that member divided by sum of the stiffness factors of all the joints meeting at that point. That is the distribution factor for the intermediate joint. Now, distribution factor for a hinged or roller support at the end of the beam is taken as 1. And distribution factor for a fixed support at the end of a beam is taken as 0. That means distribution factor of this joint will become 1. Because the end support is hinged. Distribution factor of this joint will be 0 because the end support is fixed. No distribution should be done in a moment if the far end is fixed. If far end is hinged, then full moment will be distributed. We will see that with numerical in numerical problems. That is about distribution factor. For the calculation of the distribution factor, stiffness factors of all the members should be calculated, and stiffness factors are calculated based on the end conditions. Now, example for distribution factor. Here we can understand the stiffness and distribution factor very clearly. In a continuous beam ABCD, BC is the intermediate joint, is intermediate member, AB and CD are the end members. If you take joint B, at joint B, there are two members BA and BC. That is BA and BC. Stiffness factor of the member BA will be 3 EI by L, this one, because end support is simple. For BA, it is 3 EI by L. And for a member adjoined BC, it is 4 EI by L because it is an intermediate member. For all intermediate member, stiffness factor will be 4 EI by L. For the end member, depends upon the end support. If the end support is simply supported or roller or hinge, then it will be 3 EI by L, that is for BA. Then sum of the stiffness, it is required for the distribution factor. Sum of the stiffness, sum of the stiffness means 3 EI by L plus 4 EI by L, the sum of this at the joint B. It will be 7 EI by L. Now distribution factor for the member BA is the stiffness of that member, that is 3 EI by L divided by sum of the stiffness at that joint, that is stiffness of BA and BC. It is 7 EI by L. EI and L will cancel, left with 3 by 7. Similarly, for the member BC, stiffness of BC is 4 EI by L because it is an intermediate member. And at B, the total stiffness is stiffness of BA and BC, it is 7 EI by L. Therefore, it will be 4 EI by L divided by 7 EI by L, it will be 4 by 7. Coming to joint C, stiffness of the member CB is 4 EI by L. Because CB is an intermediate joint. For intermediate joint, stiffness factor, intermediate member, stiffness factor is 4 EI by L. Then for CD, it is an end member, but the end support is fixed. In such case also, stiffness will be 4 EI by L. Therefore, sum of the stiffness at this joint C will be 4 EI by L plus 4 EI by L. It will be 8 EI by L. Now, to calculate the distribution factor of CB and CD, it will be stiffness of CB 4 EI by L divided by sum of the stiffnesses of the joints meeting at, of the members meeting at joint C. That is stiffness of CB 4 EI by L and stiffness of CD 4 EI by L summation 8 EI by L. It will be 4 by 8. We can see another example for the calculation of the distribution factor. Now, intermediate members here, both AB and BC are the end members. Therefore, if you take joint B for the calculation of the distribution factor, BA, it is an end member and end support is simple support. Therefore, coming to the distribution factor of this overhanging beam, overhanging continuous beam. Joint B, stiffness will not be there because BA, it is A, is overhanging, that is no support, therefore no stiffness, zero. Coming to BC, it is 3EI by L because this end is simply supported. Total stiffness is 3EI by L. Therefore, distribution factor will be 0 for this, that is for BA. And for BC, it is 1 because stiffness and sum of the stiffness will be same. Coming to joint C, members are 2, CB and CD. Now for CB, end support is hinged, therefore stiffness will be 3AI by L. Then for CD, that is also end member, but end support is fixed, therefore it is 4EI by L. Sum of the stiffnesses at joint C will be 3EI by L plus 4EI by L, 7EI by L. Therefore, distribution factor for the member CB is the stiffness of the member CB, 3AI by L, divided by total stiffness at that joint C, it is 7EI by L, it is 3 by 7. Now, for the member CD, stiffness is 4EI by L and total stiffness is 7EI by L, it will be 4 by 7. Now, the next step is modification of the moments. This modification will come if end in a continuous beam are hinged or supported, simply supported, or overhanging only. That is, modify the fixed end moments if there is hinged or roller support at the ends, or if there is an overhanging in the beam as shown in figure below, by carrying over half of the balancing moment to the opposite ends of the span. Remember, this modifying fixed end moments will come only if end supports are hinged or roller like this or overhanging, not for other fixed support. By considering AB, BC are fixed ends, fixed beams, if we calculate fixed end moment, suppose if it is minus 67.22 and this is 96.11, that is MFAB, MFBA are minus 67.22 and plus 96.11. And MFBC is minus 29.7 And MFCB is plus 51.3. And because of overhanging, if there is some load, then MCD is minus 60. Because of the overhanging loading, minus 60 is it. Now, how to do balancing? It is, A is inter support. That means the net moment will be zero. Therefore, the moment which is calculated by considering this as, by assuming this as fixed end, should be made zero. To make this zero, we should add plus 67.22. Therefore, end moment will come zero. And this should be carried to the far end for balancing. That is 67.22 by 50%, that is 33.61. Then coming to the joint, end joint C, there is overhanging, minus 60, that will remain same because of the overhanging effect. But here there is unbalanced moment, 51.3 and minus 60 will be minus 8.7. Therefore, for balancing, it should be plus 8.7. And that should be carried to the far end by 50%, that is 4.35. Therefore, here the modified moment will be zero because it is hinged. Here the modified moment will be minus 60. And this will be plus 60. That means it will be in equilibrium. Now the modified moments at joint B, BA will be the sum of these two, 96 and 33, 129. And minus 29 and 4, it is plus 4, it is minus 25.35. This is modifying the fixed end moments. If there is hinge or roller support at the end or overhanging portion. That is carry over the moment is the next step. This is the most important in this moment distribution method. Now it is defined as the moment induced at the fixed end of the beam by the action of a moment applied at the other end, which is hinged. Carry over moment is the same nature of the applied moment. Now continue the cycle of balancing and carry over 50%, that is with a carry over factor of 0.5, till the joints reach equilibrium state when the unbalanced moment is negligible. Take the sum of all the moments, fixed end moments, balancing moment, carry over moment at each end to get the final end moments on the left and right hand side of the supports. Balance all the joints by applying balancing moments in the proportion of distribution factor. These steps we will understand very clearly by taking some numerical problems. Now, To summarize the procedure, of moment distribution method, if there are continuous beams or rigid beams, first step is calculation of the fixed head moments by assuming the ends are fixed. The fixed head moments depends upon the loading. If an eccentric point load, then the fixed end moments will be PAB squared by L squared and PA squared B by L squared. Now, if a beam carries an UDL, then end moments, fixed end moments will be WL squared by 2, WL squared by 2, to both the ends. Now, point load at the midspan of the beam, then fixed end moments will be WL by 8 and WL by 2, WL by 8 on both the ends. If a beam carries a triangular load with maximum intensity at the center and zero intensity at both the support, then fixed end moments, left end will be 5 WL squared by 96, and at the right end also, because of symmetrical loading, 5 WL squared by 96. If UL or triangular load is distributed in such a way that zero end at one end and maximum intensity at the other end, fixed end moment at an end where maximum intensity occurs, it is WL squared by 20, and where intensity of the triangular load is zero at that end, fixed end moment will be WL squared by 30. You can see this with two examples. And because of the moment, fixed end moment will be like this. And due to sinking, it is 6 EI delta by L squared and 6 EI delta by L squared at both the ends with proper sign convention. Then, stiffness factors. Now, stiffness factor in a continuous beam and in rigid frame, for all intermediate members, it will be 4 EI by L. Then stiffness factor for the edge members depends on the end support. If the end support is fixed, then for that end member, stiffness factor will be 4 EI by L. If the end support is inched or roller, then the stiffness factor will be 3 EI by L. If we see example, here a continuous beam AB and BC stiffness factor for BA, it is 4 EI by L because end support is fixed. BC, it is 3 EI by L because end support is hinge. Then KCB, it is 4 EI by L, and KCD it will be 0. Then coming to the distribution factor, for the members meeting at an intermediate joint is based on the stiffness coefficient of the members. Distribution factor will be stiffness of that member divided by sum of the stiffnesses at that joint. That is, distribution factor, if there are three members at a joint, then stiffness factor of that joint divided by sum of the stiffness factors of the joints meeting at that point. Similarly, for the second member, stiffness of that member divided by sum of the stiffnesses. For the third member, stiffness of that member divided by sum of the stiffnesses of the members meeting at that point. Now, distribution factor for an hinged or roller support at the end of the beam is taken as 1. And distribution factor for a fixed support at the end of the beam is taken as 0. You can see this example. I explain. That is, here it gives you for all the cases A, B, C, D, a continuous beam, wherein AB is the end member with end support as hinged, BC is an intermediate joint, intermediate member, and CD is an end member with end edge is fixed. Therefore, if you take BA as end support is hinged, stiffness will be 3 EI by L, and for BC it is an intermediate member, it will be 4 EI by L. And if you take joint C, for CB it is an intermediate member, therefore 4 EI by L. For CD it is an end member, but end support is fixed, therefore it is 4 EI by L. Only this, for BA it is 3 EI by L because end support is simple support and sum of the stiffnesses and distribution factor is calculated by stiffness of that member divided by total stiffness of the members meeting at that joint. Now, similarly, some two examples are given for the calculation of stiffness and distribution factor. Then modifying the moments or modifying the fixed end moments. This is done in the beams where if the end supports are hinged or roller and if there is an overhanging beam. If both ends are fixed, then there is no need for this modifying of fixed bend moments. Directly, we will go for carryover in such cases. Now, carryover the moment and balancing will be done 50% and based on the distribution factor, and the final moments will be fixed end moment, balancing moment, carryover moment will be taken into account. Now, we will see some numerical problems. We'll take it in the next hour.